Problem number four. The points of trisection of a string are pulled aside the same distance on opposite sides of the position of equilibrium. And the string is released from rest derive an expression for the displacement of the string at any subsequent time and show that the midpoint of the string always remains at rest. The points of trisection of a string are pulled aside the same distance on opposite sides of the position of equilibrium and the string is released from rest. At the equilibrium position, at the points of trisection, at one point of trisection, the string is pulled upward direction. And at the another point of trisection on the string, so the string is pulled downwards because on opposite sides of the string, so we are pulling same distance on both sides of the equilibrium position at the points of trisection. And the string is released from the rest position. From that position, the string is released to vibrate. So there we will find the vibrations of a string and waves will be formed. For this, we have to derive an expression for the displacement of the string at any subsequent time. And also show that the midpoint of the string always remains at the rest. That means the displacement at the midpoint of the string is a zero. We have to show this one. Now solution. Now take the string of length L along the x-axis . This is Y, this is X-axis. Now, string of length OA, this is O, this is A, string of length OA of length L, string OA of length L. So divide this string of length L into three parts, trisection. That means three parts. So that is 0 to L by 3, one part, L by 3 to 2L by 3, one part, 2L by 3 to L, 2L by 3 to L, that is 3L by 3, 3 gets cancelled, we get L. So, these are the three parts of the string, trisection of the string. The point of trisection, L by 3 is one point of trisection, 2L by 3 is another point of trisection. We have to pull at both the points on opposite sides. At L by 3, we are pulling the string in the upward direction. And again, at 2L by 3, we are pulling down the string through a distance h. How much of distance we pulled upward and we pulled downward. On both sides we pulled the same distance, that is h. This is OA. B. C. this is P, this is a Q. I write this point here, B. Now this is L by 3. From B to C, 2L by 3. Again, B to C, L by 3, L by 3 plus L by 3, 2L by 3. Again, C to A, L by 3. We divide the string OA of length L into three parts. First part is L by 3, second part is another L by 3, third part is another L by 3. So therefore, here the point is L by 3, here the point is 2L by 3, here the point is L. So the points of trisection is, at one point of trisection is B, here we pulled the string upward direction through a distance H, and again at the point 2L by 3, another point of trisection, here we are pulling the string downwards as given in the problem, pulled aside the same distance on opposite sides through a distance H, therefore this is minus H, therefore here the point is L by 3 comma 0. Origin 0 comma 0, this is L by 3 comma 0, therefore the point P is, x coordinate is L by 3 and y coordinate is H. And again, here the point is, this is 2L by 3 comma 0, and the points of Q, this is x coordinate is 2L by 3 comma y coordinate is minus H. This is A, here the point is L comma 0, x coordinate is L because the length of the string is L. These are the coordinates of all the points. Initially, this is the form of the string at equilibrium position. From this rest position, we are releasing the string to vibrate. So therefore, this is three parts, OP and PQ and QA. We have to find the equation of OP, equation of PQ and equation of QA to get the initial displacement of the string at time t is equal to 0 by using two-point formula. Now let B and C be the points of trisection of the string. Let B and C be the points of trisection of the string. Initially, the string is held in the form OPQA. Initially, where PB is equal to CQ is equal to H. The distance is H. We pulled upward through a distance H here. We pulled here through a distance H downwards. Now to find the initial displacement of the string. Initial displacement of the string, that means at a time t equal to 0, first find the initial displacement of the string. In the previous problems, the initial displacement of the string clearly given. But here, some geometrical representation of the string is given. So we have to find from this geometrical representation the initial displacement of the string. Now, this is the geometrical description of the given string. Initially, OP. First, we have to find the equation of OP. After that, equation of PQ. After that, and then equation of QA. First, we have to find the equation of OP by using the two-point formula. This is x1, y1. This is x2, y2. Equation of OP is by using the two-point formula y minus y1 by y2 minus y1 is equal to x minus x1 by x2 minus x1. This implies y minus y1, y1 value is 0, by y2 value is a h minus y1 value 0 is equal to x minus x1 value is a also 0 by x2 minus x1, x2 value is L by 3 minus x1 value is 0. Substituting x1, y1, x2, y2 in the above formula. We just substituted these two points, x1, y1, x2, y2. Now simplifying this, y by h is equal to 3 by l reciprocal into x. Therefore, by cross multiplication, y is equal to 3h by l into x. Y is equal to 3h by l into x. This is the point or initial displacement between O and P, where x varies from 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to L by 3. in between O and P, x varies from 0 to L by 3C. X varies from O to B, therefore that is 0 to L by 3. By using the same formula, we can find the equation of PQ. Here x1, y1, x1 is L by 3, y1 is h, x2, y2, x2 is 2L by 3, y2 is minus h. Now equation of PQ is y minus, same formula, y minus y1 by y2 minus y1. So y minus y1, that is a h by y2, that is a minus h minus y1, that is h equal to x minus x1, that is L by 3, by x2, that is 2L by 3, minus x1, that is L by 3. Here we substituted the values of x1, y1, x2, y2. This implies y minus h by minus 2h equal to x minus L by 3 by 2L by 3 minus L by 3, that is L by 3. Now again simplify by cross multiplication. This implies y minus h is equal to minus reciprocal of L by 3, 3 by L. By cross multiplication, that is 3 into 2, 6h by L into x minus L by 3. Again, this can be written as y is equal to h minus 6h by L into x minus L by 3. Now taking L as LCM, this implies y is equal to L is the LCM, LH minus multiplication 6H into x minus into minus plus 3 ones, 3 twos, 2 L into H LH by L. Therefore, this implies y is equal to LH plus 2 LH, that is 3 LH minus 6 HX by L. Therefore, here now this implies here y is equal to, taking 3h as a common factor by L, LCM, that is equal to L minus 3 twos 6 into x, L minus 2x. This is in between L by 3 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2L by 3. X varies from L by 3 to 2L by 3. See, in between P and Q, x varies from L by 3 to 2L by 3. X varies from L by 3 to 2L by 3. Now we have to find the equation of QA. Here x1, y1, 2L by 3 comma minus h, x2, y2, L comma 0. This is a x1, this is x2, this is a y1, this is a y2. Equation of QA is y minus y1 minus h, minus or minus plus h, by y2 minus y1. Y2 is 0, minus or minus plus h is equal to x minus x1, that is 2L by 3, by x2 L minus x1, 2L by 3. We substituted the points x1, y1, x2, y2. This implies y plus h by h is equal to x minus 2l by 3 by l minus 2l by 3, that is 3 minus 2l, l by 3, by cross multiplication. This is equal to 3 by L into H. So 3H by L, again it is minus H. Therefore Y is equal to 3H by L into X minus 2L by 3 minus H. We are writing plus H in the right hand side. It becomes a minus H. This is equal to LCM is L, 3HX minus 3H into 2L by 3. 3, 3 cancel, that is equal to 2L into H minus, since L is a LCM, this is a LH by L. Therefore, this is equal to 3HX minus 3LH. So therefore, throughout we have 3H is a common factor, 3H by L is a common factor. Therefore, X minus that is equal to 3LH. We have taken 3H as a common factor L. So therefore, 3H is a common factor, by L is already there. So therefore, X is a common factor, X is the remaining factor, and 3LH, we have taken 3H as a common factor, L is the remaining factor. Here, X varies from 2L by 3 to L. Therefore, Y is equal to 3H by L into X minus L, where X varies from 2L by 3 less than or equal to X less than or equal to L in between Q and A. So X varies from 2L by 3 to L, 2L by 3 to L. So here the function for the initial displacement of the string at time t equal to 0 is divided into 3 subintervals. One is 0 to L by 3, another one is L by 3 to 2L by 3, and another one is final one 2L by 3 to L, because the string is divided into 3 subparts, therefore we get the initial displacement in the each 3 subparts or 3 subintervals of the entire interval 0 to L. Now we have to write the initial conditions and boundary conditions to solve the given problem. That means derive an expression for the displacement of the string at any subsequent time, and also to show that the midpoint of the string always remains at rest. So in the next class we will write the boundary conditions and initial conditions, and then suitable solution. After that, substitute each initial and boundary conditions one after the other in the suitable solution to find the displacement of the string at any time t, and to find the displacement at midpoint of the string. So we will continue in the next session.